Hi students, you have studied about galvanic cell and you have studied the topic thermodynamics. In thermodynamics, you know, you can identify whether the reaction is spontaneous or non-spontaneous on the basis of the value of Gibbs energy. In this video, we shall consider about the thermodynamics of galvanic cell. It depends upon Gibbs energy. And so Gibbs energy of a cell reaction and cell potential. What is the relation between Gibbs energy and cell potential? We have to consider in this video. Now, you know that if there is decrease in Gibbs energy, that is minus delta G, if the value of Gibbs energy is negative, then the reaction is spontaneous. If the value of delta G is positive, then the reaction is non-spontaneous. That is, if there is decrease in Gibbs energy, the reaction is spontaneous reaction. If there is increase in Gibbs energy, the reaction is non-spontaneous reaction. Like this, we have studied about the cell potential also. Cell potential, we have denoted it EMF of a cell. E cell, if the value of E cell is greater than zero, that is, if the value of EMF of a cell is positive, then the reaction is spontaneous reaction. And if it is negative, then the reaction is non-spontaneous. That is, the reaction which takes place in any galvanic cell, which is called as redox reaction. If that redox reaction is positive, then we can say that E cell or EMF of a cell is positive. And if the reaction is non-spontaneous, then EMF of a cell is negative. You have to remember this. Now, here we shall consider the work done in a galvanic cell. During working of a galvanic cell, the work done, which is called as electrical work, is the product of electrical work is the product of charge which is passed through that cell into EMF of a cell or cell potential. So electrical work which is taking place in a galvanic cell is the product of charge passed through the cell into the potential difference, or it is called as EMF of a cell. Then you know that the charge on 1 mole of electrons, charge on 1 mole of electrons is equal to 1 Faraday, or it is equal to 96500 coulombs. Suppose n number of moles of electrons are passed, or they are taking place in a cell reaction, then the total charge pass, that is denoted by N into F. F is the charge on 1 mole of electrons, 1 Faraday. You know the definition of Faraday. 1 Faraday is the charge which is present on 1 mole of electrons. That is, 1 mole is equal to the number of electrons which is equal to Avogadro's number. So if you take 6.022 × 10⁻³³ electrons, the total charge on these electrons, that is equal to 1 Faraday, and it is in coulombs, 96500. Now suppose in any cell reaction, number of electrons, which number of moles of electrons are N. So the charge is equal to N into F into E cell. And so remember here, the electric work done, electrical work, which we can denote as W, is equal to N into F into E cell. Understand each term here. N is equal to number of moles of electrons which are taking place or which are involving in a cell reaction. F is Faraday and E cell is the potential of the cell. Now, Gibbs. And the scientist Gibbs, he concluded that the decrease in the Gibbs energy is equal to work done in a galvanic cell. So decrease in Gibbs energy, which is denoted by minus delta G. So minus delta G is equal to NF into E cell. Remember that the work done is equal to minus delta G. And minus delta G is equal to electrical work done, which is we have determined NF into E cell. And so remember here, minus delta G इज इक्वल टू एन एफ इंटू ई सेल और ई एम एफ ऑफ अ सेल. इफ ऑल दीज आर एट स्टैंडर्ड कंडीशन, दैट इज द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ ऑल द रिएक्टेंट्स आर वन मोलर, और इफ यू आर टेकन द गैसेस देन the pressure of the gas is 1 atmosphere, temperature is 25 degree Celsius. If all the standard conditions are followed, then this equation becomes minus delta Z zero n number of moles as it is F Faraday and it is standard cell potential. So for standard potential cell potential, the relation between Gibbs energy and E cell, E zero cell is given like this: minus delta zero, delta Z zero is equal to NF into E zero cell. Now, here in thermodynamics topic, we have studied that delta Z zero or delta Z is extensive property. That is, it depends upon the quantity of the substance. If you increase the quantity, then value of delta G will increase. If you decrease the quantity of the substance, then delta Z zero will decrease. Means delta Z zero value depends upon quantity of the substance, and that quantity is called as extensive quantity. Extensive quantity. Now, as delta Z zero is extensive quantity, here we shall consider what is E zero cell, whether it is extensive or intensive. Suppose this equation is written like this. Here you can say E zero cell is equal to minus delta Z zero upon NF. Now, suppose we have this reaction. In Daniell cell, the reaction taking place is Zn plus Cu plus 2 gives Zn plus 2 plus Cu. Now, for this reaction, the number of moles of electrons which are involving is equal to 2. You know, N is equal to 2 here. How? Zn gives 2 electrons, gets converted into Zn plus 2, and these 2 electrons are taken by Cu plus 2 and they are converted into Cu. So N is equal to 2 here. Here, if you write the equation for this reaction, E0 cell is equal to minus delta Z0 upon 2 into F, you can say. Now suppose we have increased the quantity of all these reactants. Suppose this equation is multiplied by 2. You have to multiply the whole equation by 2. So what will happen here? What will be the value of N here? The value of N will also gets doubled, and so N will become is equal to 4. Now remember that as delta Z0 is extensive quantity, here if we increase the quantity of the substance, the value of delta Z0 will increase. And so, for this reaction, this value will become minus 2 delta Z0, and this value will become as 4F, because this value is doubled. Now, what will happen here? Here again you can obtain the equation as minus delta Z0 upon 2F. See this value. What has happened? We have increased the quantity of the substance. If we increase the quantity, delta Z0 will increase, Gibbs energy will increase, because it is extensive quantity. And here E0 cell, it remains as it is. So E0 cell is not extensive property, it is intensive property. From this, you can say that E0 cell is intensive property. It is independent of quantity of substance. It is independent of quantity of substance. Whatever may be the quantity of the substance, whatever may be the number of moles. Remember, if you increase the quantity, the number of moles of electrons are increased, and therefore there will not be any change in the value of E0 cell, and this can be proved by using this relation between Gibbs energy and E0 cell. E0 cell is equal to minus delta Z0 upon NF. Delta Z0 will increase or decrease with increase or decrease in the quantity of substance. But remember that as we increase the quantity, value of N will increase in the same proportion. If we decrease the quantity, value of N will decrease in the same proportion. So this ratio will remain constant. And so E0 cell will remain constant. Means E0 cell is independent of quantity of substance. And so EMF of a cell is intensive quantity. E0 cell is intensive property. It will not depend upon the quantity of substance. We have said that E0 cell of Daniell cell is E0 cell of Daniell cell is 1.1 volt. Whatever may be the quantity we have taken of Zn or Cu plus 2 or Zn plus 2 obtained and Cu atoms obtained, whatever may be the quantity of these reactants, here E0 cell is 1.1 volt. That means it does not depend upon the quantity of the substance. So remember, here we have proved from this equation, EMF of a cell is an intensive quantity. Now we will see the relation between standard cell potential and equilibrium constant. Now this equilibrium constant we have studied in the topic ionic equilibria. What is equilibrium constant? You know, standard cell potential and equilibrium constant, the relation between them can be derived from the equation. Now you know the change in Gibbs energy, that is minus delta Z0, it is given by the equation NF E0 cell, NF into E0 cell. In thermodynamics, we know that delta Z0 for any chemical reaction is equal to minus RT ln K. In thermodynamics, you know this relation, delta Z0, that is change in Gibbs energy, is equal to minus R is gas constant, T is absolute temperature, and K is equilibrium constant for the reaction. Now if you combine these two equations, now remember here minus delta Z0 is equal to NF E0 cell, and here you can obtain minus delta Z0 is equal to RT into ln K. And so from these two equations you can say that NF E0 cell is equal to RT into ln K. Ln is log to the base E. From this equation, E0 cell is equal to RT upon NF ln K. Now if this ln is converted to log to the base 10, then we have to multiply this equation by 2.303. So it will become 2.303 RT upon NF log of K. Again, you know that the value of R is constant, the value of N is constant for any reaction, for value of F is constant, F is 1 Faraday, which is equal to 96500 coulombs. If the temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, suppose the temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, then here these values we can convert into according to Nernst's equation, which is 0.0592 upon N will change when the reaction will change into log of K. So from this you can obtain the relation as E0 cell, standard EMF of a cell is equal to 0.0592 upon N into log of K, where E0 cell is standard cell potential, N is the number of electrons which are involved in a cell reaction, and K is equilibrium constant. For example, suppose we have the reaction which is taking place in Daniell cell. So Zn plus 2
plus Cu plus 2 gives Zn plus 2 plus Cu. For this reaction, if we write the expression for E0 cell, the equation can be modified as at 25 degrees Celsius, E0 cell, you can obtain E0 cell is equal to 25 degrees Celsius. We have taken the temperature, and so this will value will become 0.0592 upon N. What is the value of N here? The number of electrons, number of moles of electrons taking place in a reaction is 2 into log of equilibrium constant. You have to write the expression for equilibrium constant here, and here remember that for solid substances, here Cu is in solid state, Zn it is in solid state. For solid substances, the concentrations are taken as unity, and so log of concentration of Zn plus 2 upon concentration of Cu plus 2. So remember, you can calculate the value of E0 cell from the value of equilibrium constant also, 0.0592 upon 2 into log of concentration of Zn plus 2 upon concentration of Cu plus 2. Here remember, all the concentrations are 1 molar, that is we have taken Cu plus 2 concentration is 1 molar, concentration of Zn plus ions is 1 molar. While constructing the Daniell cell, all the standard cell conditions are followed, and you can calculate E0 cell of the reaction. And the relation between standard cell potential and equilibrium constant can be understood easily by solving this problem. See this problem here. Equilibrium constant of the reaction is given, twice Cu plus aqueous gives Cu plus 2 aqueous plus Cu solid is 1.2 into 10 raised to 6. What is the standard potential of a cell in which the reaction takes place? The reaction which is taking place in a cell is given to you, and equilibrium constant is given, and what is asked? Standard cell potential. Now you know E0 cell. We know that E0 cell is equal to, here the temperature is not given, and so we can easily consider it as 25 degrees Celsius upon N. Because at 25 degrees Celsius, the values of 2.303 into R into T upon N into F. Here N will change as the reaction changes. And so 2.303 RT upon F, this value if you calculate, it will be 0.0592 upon N into log of K. In this problem, temperature is not given. Another temperature is not given, that is whether it is less than 25 degrees Celsius or greater than 25 degrees Celsius, it is not given, and so we have considered it as 25 degrees Celsius, and we can use this equation for calculation of E0 cell. Now E0 cell we have to calculate. Value of K is given, which is 1.2 into 10 raised to 6. Value of N we have to determine. Here this is the reaction which takes place in a cell. We can write this reaction 2Cu plus. Remember, this reaction is somewhat different. We know we have used Cu plus 2 ions generally, but here 2Cu plus ions are given. This can be written as Cu plus plus. Cu plus plus Cu plus, 2Cu plus ions are there, gives Cu plus 2 and Cu. See here, we'll explain this reaction. Cu plus ions are there, they are 2 in number. So we have written this reaction as Cu plus plus Cu plus gives Cu plus 2 plus Cu. Now Cu plus ion is converted into Cu plus 2. Why or how? One electron is less, and here two electrons are less. That means here there is loss of electrons. So this ion is oxidized. This is oxidation reaction. And here in this ion, for this ion if you consider, Cu plus ion is converted into Cu atom. what is happened? Cu plus ion is converted into Cu atom. Means here the electron is gained by this Cu. See here. One Cu plus, it loses one electron and get converted into Cu plus 2 ion. And another Cu plus ion, it accept the electron and get converted into Cu atom. So this is a redox reaction. First, you have to understand what is the value of N. For the determination of value of N, you have to write this reaction, that is oxidation half reaction and reduction half reaction. And you know that in redox reaction, electrons must be balanced. And so for this reaction, remember here, it is somewhat different. One Cu plus ion is oxidized and another Cu plus ion is reduced. The same ions are there, Cu plus ions are there, but one is oxidized and another is reduced. Cu plus ion is converted into Cu plus 2 by donating one electron, and Cu plus ion is converted into Cu atom by accepting electron. So what is the value of N here? The number of electrons which are transferred is equal to 1, and so N is equal to 1. So here you can substitute the value of N is equal to 1, and therefore E0 cell is equal to 0.0592 and is equal to 1 into log of K. K value is given, it is 1.2 into 10 raised to 6. So it is equal to 0.0592 into log of this value, you have to take, that is log of 1.2 into 10 raised to 6, characteristic will be 6, 6 point, log of 12 is 0.0792. And if you multiply these two values, you can obtain it as 0.36 volt. And so E0 cell is equal to 0.36 volt. So remember, we can use this relation. For this, we have solved this problem. That is, what is the relation between standard cell potential and equilibrium constant? For that, equilibrium constant is given to you. You have to take the log of this value. For that, you have to determine N. If you know the value of N at 25 degrees Celsius, you can substitute directly 0.0592 and do the calculation for E0 cell. We'll see the next problem. See here, calculate standard Gibbs energy change, standard Gibbs energy change and equilibrium constant at 25 degrees Celsius for the cell reaction. Cd solid plus Sn plus 2 aqueous gives Cd plus 2 aqueous plus Sn solid. E0 Cd is equal to, the standard potential of Cd electrode is given, which is equal to minus 0.403 volt. E0 Sn is equal to minus 0.136 volt. Write formula of a cell. All the concepts will be cleared here in this problem. Write a formula of a cell. The question is, write a formula of a cell. What is given to you? Here the cell reaction is given and the standard cell potentials are given. Standard electrode potentials are given. Now, from the standard cell potentials, you can calculate standard EMF of a cell also. Now, remember here, E0 Cd is given and E0 Sn is given. For writing the formula of a cell, you know that the cell or the electrode where the standard electrode potential is more, at that electrode there will be reduction reaction. You know this E0 Cd, here it is not mentioned whether it is oxidation potential or reduction potential. If it is not mentioned, then it is reduction potential. Now remember here, if you compare these two values, minus 0.403 and minus 0.136, this minus 0.136 is greater than minus 0.403. So E0 Sn or Sn atoms, Sn ions have more tendency to gain electrons, that is to get reduced, than Cd plus ions. And so here at Sn electrode there will be reduction reaction, and so it will work as cathode. Remember here, this Sn will work as cathode because its potential is higher than this, and so this will work as anode. For writing a cell formula, here you must determine, you have to determine which electrode is working as cathode and which is working as anode. Only cell reaction is given to you. From this cell reaction, you can determine there are two half cells, that is CD plus 2 and SN plus 2 and SN. Now you have to determine which is cathode and which is anode here. And for that, here the values of standard electrode potential are given. Standard electrode potential of SN electrode is greater than standard electrode potential of CD. So SN electrode will work as cathode and CD electrode will work as anode. So the first answer we can write E. The formula of a cell, we can write as here CD electrode will work as anode. It is written on the left hand side. So CD solid, CD plus 2 aqueous. Here we can write 1 molar because standard potentials are given. Double vertical line, SN plus 2 aqueous, the concentration is 1 molar, and SN solid. This electrode will work as negative electrode, that is anode. This electrode will work as positive electrode, that is cathode. So remember, this is the first answer, write formula of a cell. From the values of electrode potential, we can determine which is cathode and which is anode, and you can write the cell formula. Now from this you can calculate E0 cell, because here for standard Gibbs energy or equilibrium constant we require the value of E0 cell, and so E0 cell, you know that it is equal to E0 cathode minus E0 anode. If you calculate this value, E0 cathode is given, which is minus 0.136 minus E0 anode, that is CD electrode, that is minus 0.403. So it will be minus 0.136 plus 0.403. So 0.403 minus 0.136, and if you calculate this value, it will be 0.267 volt. So E0 cell we have determined, we have calculated as 0.267 volt. If you know E0 cell, you can calculate Gibbs energy and equilibrium constant. So the second step, we will determine what is the value of delta Z0. The first is we have written the cell formula, and from cell formula we have calculated the value of delta E0 cell. Now write down the equation for delta Z0. Delta Z0 is equal to minus N F E0 cell. Delta Z0 is equal to minus NF E0 cell. What is the value of N here? The second problem we have to calculate, that is standard Gibbs energy, delta Z0. What is the value of N? From the cell reactions, the value of N is 2. What is the value of F? It is in Coulomb, 96500. Into E0 cell is 0.267. If you calculate this value by using the log table, the value will be minus 515231, and the unit of it will be joule, that is 515231 joule, or minus 51.531 kilojoule. Here delta Z0 is equal to minus NF E0 cell. E0 cell we have determined, N we can obtain from this cell reaction, 2 electrons, 2 moles of electrons are transferred, and so 2 into 96500 into 0.267 is equal to minus 51531 joule. So the value of delta Z0 here, it is negative. Remember, E0 cell for the spontaneous cell reaction is positive, and so if E0 cell is positive, then delta Z0 will be negative here. Why? Because the value of N cannot be negative, value of F cannot be negative. E0 cell can be either positive or negative. If E0 cell is positive, value of delta Z0 is negative, means this reaction, the reaction takes place in this cell, is a spontaneous chemical reaction. If E0 cell is negative, then this reaction is non-spontaneous, and so this value is negative. And here by this negative sign, minus minus will become plus, and so you can say that delta Z0 will be positive, so the reaction will be non-spontaneous. Like this, from the value of delta zero and E0 cell, you can conclude that if E0 cell is positive, then delta Z0 will be negative, means if E0 cell is positive, then the cell reaction which takes place in a cell is a spontaneous chemical reaction. Now, the third we have to calculate is, what is equilibrium constant? Equilibrium constant, the relation is, here 25 degrees Celsius is given, the temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, and you know this relation, E0 cell is equal to RT, this equation is modified, that is 0.0592 upon 2 log of K. We have to calculate K here. E0 cell is given. Why we have taken N? N is equal to 2, because 0.0592 upon N, this is the equation here, but remember here I had taken directly 2, because 2 is the value of N here in this reaction. Now we have to determine K, so log of K is equal to E0 cell into 2 divided by 0.0592. E0 cell, we know it is 0.267 into 2 divided by 0.0592. If you calculate this value, it will be 9.0203. And here this value is of log of K, so K is equal to, taking antilog on both sides, K is equal to antilog of 9.023. If you see the antilog of 0.023, it is equal to 1.05 into 10^9. So for this reaction, the value of equilibrium constant K is equal to 1.05 into 10^9. Like this, from the given information, we can calculate, or first we have written what is the cell formula. If the values of standard cell potential, standard electrode potentials are given, then we have calculated E0 cell. From the value of E0 cell, we can determine what is standard Gibbs energy and what is equilibrium constant for the reaction.